Just really proud of our guys for their fight. They really responded well this week in practice, and I was really proud of how we practiced this week. You know, we have a football team that will be as good as we practice. If we don't really have great practices and really high energy and a lot of physicality, we're not going to play well on Saturday. And so very, very proud of how we bounced back. I'm proud of our coaching staff, how we handled our kids this week. And they responded. We didn't play perfect. We had some plays and some things we could have done better. We came up short on some fourth downs, gave up a couple of big plays on screens. But overall, we fought, and we played really hard for four quarters. Very proud of the block punt and Dane Olson. You know, he's one of those kids that was a walk-on and earned his way, and all he does is give us his best every time he gets a chance to play, and really proud of him. Really proud of some of our defensive kids. Dom Jones played well today. Boom Jock had a good game, bunch of tackles. Mukende had an excellent game, and those guys continue to improve and get better. Armani Winfield, I thought he came back. He had a drop on a third down, and he came back in the second half and got a big play for a touchdown that we needed, and that was an excellent throw by Braden as well. And, I'm really proud of Braden. His numbers don't always look like they used to last year at times, but he's doing a lot of good things to help us win football games. And he's very much involved in the running game. He's very much involved in making sure we're in the right place. And I think his maturity and leadership has been really good. And so proud of how he bounced back today. We got 2 weeks now where we can kind of get healed up a little bit. And it's going to be important that we get some guys back, Torrey back. I'm hoping we get Neuer back. I hope we get DeAndre Gill back. We just have some really good players that haven't been on the field that we really need to get back. And hopefully Alex Foster will be able to come back as well. But we got a lot of good players that got experience today that we're going to need to go down the stretch. It'll be an important game in 2 weeks when we play Oregon State. Good football team, good program. And, this game doesn't count towards our conference, but it's an important game to propel us into the conference. So, overall, I'm just pleased with how our kids responded today.
You talk a lot about players you hope to get back, but honestly, you look at Avery, he had a rough 23, for a lot of different reasons. To see him perform the way he has the last couple of weeks, what's that tell you about what he's gone through?
Avery's a kid. I've had him since he was young freshman. And, Avery, Torrey, Jacob Gardner, I know those kids as well as anybody. And Avery's he's built from the right stuff. He's a tremendous person. He's been through a lot of tough times in his life. And he's always remained positive. And he continues to work. He's a really good teammate, and I'm just really proud of him. He showed me a lot at the end of the Northern Colorado game when he got in there and he ran that last touchdown in, and he took about five or six defenders with him and pushed into the end zone. And he really showed me a lot of determination there, and we've been looking for ways to get him in the game. We played a little ponies tonight. We played two backs at the same time, and Avery was in there. And we'll continue to do that, but really proud of Avery. Really did a great job tonight.
You put a focus on the run game in the offseason. Last year you had 7 explosive runs all year. Tonight you had 6.
Yeah. It's amazing when we have explosive runs, it changes our team. And that's a deflating thing for defense when you can run the ball on them like that. And when you can get chunks of yards, that changes the game. And so we want to continue to build on that. We still have some young receivers that just haven't played with Braden very much. On the interception, Braden thought Caleb was going to come in front of the defender. That's why – and he's given Torrey and some of his other guys that same ball hundreds of times. And it was just a little bit miscommunication. So we got to keep cleaning that up and – bringing those young players along. It was great to see Armani bounce back and get the touchdown after the third down drop. And, we'll continue to get better with those kids. I'm encouraged by that, but it's nice to have the running game to complement that, and we're going to need both, you know, as we move down the stretch.
Went up 24-3 in the third quarter there, and then obviously they kind of pushed back. Did you feel there was any kind of let off the gas, or you know, maybe let?
No, I just think we didn't execute very well for a little bit of a stretch there, and so we just got to continue to execute, you know, and be aggressive, and we will be. You know, we had a ton of short yardage plays that we didn't convert on or fourth downs, and I was not happy with that. But we got to continue to work on that and get better. That should be something that's a strength of ours. So we'll go look at it and see what we need to correct.
How frustrating is it when you do have a lot of those, like you say, third or fourth and shorts, like you're in decent spot with the sticks? You don't convert them.
You know, you just gotta be a little bit better, a little cleaner in how you block it, a little bit lower how you run it. And, you know, I was just disappointed that we didn't finish and convert on some of those.
How's Jack Howell doing?
You know, I'm not sure. I have to go in the training room and ask how he's doing. I was pleased to see him get up and move around. And, you know, you're always concerned when a kid takes a shot like that. But Jack's such a tough kid and a tough competitor. You know, I'm hoping he's fine. I'm not sure what his status is at this point.
On every long touchdown, it seemed like the offensive line really just provided like that hole for him, like big boost. Can you talk about their performance tonight?
Yeah, I think our offensive line continues to get better. You know, and we had a new kid in there starting tonight, Tanner Morley, who's a monster of a kid, and it was good to see him in there to get some action. But our line just keeps getting better and better, and we're running a lot of the same schemes over and over, and the more you run them, the more confident they get. And so really proud of them, Jacob Gardner and Drew Moss, Savion Henderson, Aaron Karras, and Tanner Morley. I mean, those guys they're good football players. They're tough, rugged players. And, you know, we've been working hard to build that part of our team.
You always want special teams to make a difference in a game, and tonight Patty puts three inside the 20 and
yeah.
Dane gets you the block at a really key moment, which turns out to be a critical play. Been happy with where your special teams have started to at least help?
Absolutely. We have a lot of pride in special teams here, and that's our standard to play well. And, you know, and we were missing Torrey tonight. You know, to get a block when Torrey's not back there to return it is huge. And so I was really proud that we were able to do that. And we got to bring that every week. You know, we got to find ways to make a difference. We need to score or set up a score on special teams. And so that's really an important part of our football team. And we have a lot of good athletes that can contribute on special teams. And tonight was a great example. And, you know, a guy like Dane, you know, we have seven guys. We call them the Magnificent Seven on special teams. And Dane is one of those. And he's not a starter, but he has a huge impact in his role on special teams, and he did a great job tonight.
Even though the score is maybe a little closer than you would have liked at the end, considering how you started, you feel like this is a good jump start into the bye and your schedule stiffening up in October?
Yeah, it's always good to win. It's always good to win. And to have to play hard and win is good. And, yeah, we have to be better in some areas, and we could have extended a couple more drives and scored. And, you know, we're a work in progress. We have to get better every day. But I'm convinced that the confidence we gain from winning is going to help this football team. And you know, it's a mental thing with our kids. We have to understand how to prepare and play a very tough competitive contest every week. And that's what we have to do. And if we continue to improve and build on what we're doing, that gives us a chance. But we will play as well as we practice. And that's the kind of group we got, and we got to practice great, and we have to work and grind. And that's what our job as coaches is to do.
Looked like you shared a big hug and some words with Armani after that.
Yeah.
How big was it to see him respond to a couple of those drops and make a play?
I thought it was big. And, you know, I kept calling his number because I wanted him to have a chance to come back. And I'm proud of him. I'm really proud of him. And he's a great kid. He's got a lot of talent and ability. And, you know, we got a lot of kids like that, you know, and Caleb Goody's similar, and Jamari Pearson. I mean, those kids have not played a lot of college snaps. And so, you know, they just need the opportunity to make some plays and build some confidence. And, you know, Braden will keep bringing those guys along, and those guys will start getting on the same page, and they'll be making more plays. So we just got to keep taking a step every time we walk on the field. Every time we practice, we get better. And so we got to continue to do that.
What do you need to do to optimize the bye week?
We're going back to work. I mean, I just talked to the players. We got to go get better next week. So we'll compete against one another. They earned a victory Monday tonight. And so we'll go back on Tuesday, and we'll have two hard practices Tuesday, Wednesday, and we'll have a good game practice on Thursday. Our coaches are going to recruit. We got to go find players. I mean, you know, that's the name of the game. We got to get better. And get quality players to come in here, and we're really seeing some positive response from, you know, us going to the Pac-12, and a lot of kids are showing more interest in us, and that's really opening some doors for us. So we got to capitalize on that.
I know you guys as offensive staff have looked at like your third down numbers, not happy with them. Do you attribute part of that to the fact that you're trying to bring along young receivers who may not know how to get perfectly open on those third down plays?
Yeah, we just got to execute a little bit better. And I think we have some guys open. I think we just missed a couple throws. I think we had a couple balls in our hands that we could have finished. And so we just got to execute a little bit better and confidently. And I think we've had pretty good plans on third down. We've had some guys open. We just got to be a little bit better.
Did you think the execution, offensive execution in the first half was – a little bit better, or was that
No, I thought we did some good things in the first half. I thought starting the game, I thought that was an excellent drive. And you know, what we're doing takes everybody. Everybody's got to execute, and that's a good thing. You know, the offensive line, the receivers have to block, the backs got to run, you know, and the play action, things that come off of it. So it's team execution, and we'll continue to get better as we do it. You know, a lot of this run scheme, we've only been doing it for a couple weeks. So it'll continue to get better. But again, we're looking at the long game. We want it to, you know, we want to be a better team in October and November than we are in September. And so playing good defense, getting more pressure on the quarterback, playing better pass coverage, running the football, taking care of the ball, all those things in the long run are going to help us win games. And so we just got to continue to press and work towards that.
Coach, were you pleased with the pass rush tonight?
I thought it was better. You know, I did think it was better. And, you know, we got them running around a little bit. And we got to be more disruptive and make life hard on those guys. And I thought today was a real good step forward.
Can you go more into your message to the team when the lead was cut to 7 early in the fourth quarter?
No, we just needed to stay together and continue to play and execute. You know, I had faith in our defense, and I believed we could move down the field to score. So, you know, we told our team this was a good, aggressive football team that was coming in here, and they have some talent, and they're building, and they're trying to build a culture and an attitude there. And they were going to come in here and play and fight us. And so we had to be prepared for that and be ready to execute and compete like crazy. And our guys did that. I think we did it for four quarters. And our execution wasn't always on point. But, you know, we got to continue to improve on that and learn from it and get better. So, you know, we'll start doing that again tomorrow.